Growing up, I was blessed with amazing older adults in my life. I always loved to listen to my Nana's stories of what her life was like living in a totally different time. One thing that I'll always appreciate was that she gave all of her grandchildren music lessons. This was her lasting gift to us. After my grandfather passed away, I would call her up and play piano for her. This was a really special time for the both of us, being connected by our shared love of music. I became aware of the changes that impacted those I loved as they aged. Both my Nana and great aunt died from a fall. My goal became to help add quality to the later years of life. This goal evolved to a focus on evaluation of value for money of lifestyle interventions. I'll never forget when a patient told me, "The moment I fractured my hip, my life changed. It has been downhill ever since." One of the life consequences of a fall is that it generates fear. The fear to do things that you want to do. The things you used to do. As I entered graduate school, I realized I was equally passionate about mathematics. And so the field of applied health economics actually provided a lot of synergy between those two areas of passion for me. Preventing things like falls can give people back their love of life. And that's where research can make a real impact. I'm motivated and I work hard, but I also really value family. I try and make my time with my kids really intentional. I like to focus on making lasting memories.
Dump that in? So then you dump it in the bowl?
I've always had a soft spot in my heart for helping older adults by improving those later years, where you often see people struggling with things that affect their quality of life. If I could go back in time and talk to my younger self, I think I would say, be bold. Have the courage to dream the dreams you envision and the persistence to follow them.